Welcome to Radio Graham. Every November with Maureen, I fly from Canberra to Brisbane and back to Canberra in one day. The purpose is to attend the annual general meeting of a listed Australian property trust, Cromwell Group. It's the only share I own. My stockbroker said I should diversify. My reply, why diversify from excellence into mediocrity?
White Ribbon Day, November 25th, is an internationally recognised day to stop domestic violence against women. It's a campaign by men for men to stop domestic violence against women.
Every silhouette you see around us today represents a woman who has lost their life just in 2015.
Oh my God.
And unfortunately, there are 56 women who have already lost their lives this year, more than one a week.
Here, what's it all for?
It's for live streaming for today's event. We've got two cameras set up and live streaming so people can watch online if they couldn't make it.
To David Kirby and Claire at the back over there, who are both here from London to be with us today and to spend some time in the business again. During the year, we saw substantial competition for quality commercial property assets in Australia. Face yields remain relatively attractive by international standards, and offshore capital continues to pursue opportunities here aggressively. I'd like to hand this over now to our CEO, Paul Wakeman.
During 2015, we saw increases in property management segment income, property valuations, and wholesale funds management earnings as a result of the $207 million acquisition of Valet Europe. These assets display defensive characteristics and have delivered a weighted property ungeared internal rate of return since acquisition of 13% and an average valuation uplift over costs of 11%. During the year, the funds management team scooped two awards at the 2014 Professional Planner Zenith Fund Awards, picking up the AREIT Award for the second consecutive year and the Direct Property Award for the first time.